Hello friends, in previous video we have studied SF6 circuit breaker. In that circuit breaker, the medium used for the arc extinction was SF6 gas. In this video, we are going to study another type of circuit breaker, that is a vacuum circuit breaker. As the name suggests, the medium used for the arc extinction is vacuum. So let us study the vacuum circuit breaker. First of all, let us see the introduction to the vacuum circuit breaker. Now we all know every circuit breaker has two contacts, one fixed contact and one moving contact. When the fault occurs, then the two contacts are separated. Same thing happens in case of vacuum circuit breaker. When the contacts are separated in vacuum, then the arc is stuck between the two contacts. Due to this, the intensely hot spots are created on the contact of separation. Now, because of these hot spots, the metal which are used for the preparing of the contacts of the circuit breaker start evaporating. This vaporization of metal basically constitutes of the plasma. Now, the amount of vapor in the plasma is proportional to the rate of vapor emission and electrodes, and hence the arc current. Now we know that in alternating current, the current reaches zero two times in one cycle. Now during the portion when the current reaches zero, arc also tends to be zero. As a result, the rate of vapor emission also becomes zero at the current zero position. Soon after the natural current zero, the remaining vapor condenses and the dielectric strain between the contacts is built up. As a result of this, the restriking voltage is prevented. The dielectric strain between the contacts is built up, that is higher than the rate of rise of restriking voltage. Due to this, the arc does not strike and the arc will be interrupted. So this is the basic principle which is used in the vacuum circuit breaker. Now let us study the electrical breakdown in high vacuum. The circuit breaker which we are studying is the vacuum circuit breaker. But before studying the vacuum circuit breaker, we should know what is meaning of vacuum. So when the pressure is below 10^5 mm of mercury, then it is called as high vacuum. Now the charged particles which are moving from one electrode to another electrode at such a high pressure causes the collision with the residual gas molecules. Hence, the ionization by collision of the particles with the atoms and molecules is very less in vacuum as compared to other types of circuit breakers. Now, if we keep the gap between the contacts of the vacuum circuit breaker small, of the order of 0.5 mm, then the certain voltage, the gap will break down. Once the gap breaks down, the current rises gradually. This phenomenon is called vacuum breakdown or vacuum spark. Now let us study the construction of the vacuum circuit breaker. Vacuum circuit breaker basically consists of the interrupter, which is nothing but the sub-assembly by the complete pole in which the arc interruption takes place. So the two contacts of the circuit breaker are placed inside the interrupter. Now there are two basic forms of the vacuum interrupter. First is interrupter suitable for single unit per pole. And second is interrupter which is suitable for multi-unit purpose. Now the interrupter generally consists of the following parts. First is enclosure. Enclosure is the assembly in which the total interrupter is placed. So it is basically made up of impermeable insulating material such as glass. The enclosure must be porous. It should be able to retain the high vacuum of the order of 10 raised to minus 10 torr. Second is end flanges. Two end flanges are used here, which are made up of the non-magnetic material. The function of the end flanges is to provide the support to the following parts. First is enclosure fixed contacts. Second is vapor condensing shield. Third, bellows. Fourth, protective cover for bellows. Now the next part is contacts. So basically contacts are made up of large stem and its large disc shaped face. Now the disc is provided with symmetrical grooves in such a way that the segment of the two contacts are not in the same line. Now by using such a geometry, the magnetic currents which are set up by the components will cause the plasma of the arc to move rapidly over the contacts, so that the plasma will not be saturated in one part of the contact, it will move rapidly towards the contact. Because of this, the concentration of arc in a particular part is prevented, so that arc remains in the diffused state. Now for the contact tip, sintered material is used, which is generally made up of copper chromium and copper bismuth. Next part is vapor condensing shield. Now these are the metallic shields which are supported on insulating housing in such a way that they cover the contact region. The metal vapor which is released from the contact surface during the arcing is condensed. This prevents the condensation of metal vapors on the insulating enclosures. Next part is metallic bellows. One end of the bellow is welded to the metal flange. The other end of the bellow is welded to the moving contact. The bellow basically permits the sealed construction of the interrupter and yet permit movement of the contact. Stainless steel bellows are basically used in vacuum interrupters. These bellows are covered by the protective shield. Next part is seals. Sealing technique is similar to the one used by the electronic valves and the power tube manufacturer. They are metal glass or ceramic shields. The diagram of the vacuum interrupter is as shown in figure. Here, these are the metal bellows. Then, this part is of the end flange. This is the moving contact and this is the fixed contact. Then, this part is the vapor condensing shield on which the metal vapor is condensed. These are the seals and it is the total enclosure of the vacuum interrupter. The interrupter is basically housed inside the sheet metal enclosure. The metal flange is supported on porcelain or epoxy insulators. The moving contact is connected to the operating mechanism by the means of the fiberglass rod. Now let us study how the arc extinction takes place inside the vacuum interrupter. The technique of arc interruption in case of vacuum circuit breaker is different as compared to other types of circuit breaker. Vacuum is basically a dielectric medium and the arc cannot sustain in the vacuum. But the separation of current carrying contacts will cause vapor to be released with the contacts. What happens is when the arc is stuck between the two contacts, heat spots are produced on the contacts of the circuit breaker. Due to these heat spots, the metallic coating on the contacts will start to vaporize and the metal vapors are produced. This will give rise to the plasma. Therefore, after the separation of the contacts, the contact space is filled with the vapors of the positive ions, which are liberated from the contact materials. The vapor density will depend on the current of the arc. Now, at the decreasing mode of the current wave, that is when the current starts to become slowly zero at the current zero position, the rate of the release of these vapors will consecutively get reduced. And after the current zero position, the medium will regain its dielectric strength if the vapor density around the contacts is reduced substantially. Once the current zero position is achieved, the dielectric strength between the contacts will increase. If the dielectric strength between the contacts becomes greater than the rate of rise of restriking voltage, then arc will be extinguished. Now there are basically two types of arcs. First is diffused arc and second is self-sustained arc. Now let us study these two types of arcs. First, diffused arc. While interrupting the current of the few hundred ampere, the arc generally will have several parallel paths. Each parallel path is basically originated at the hotspot of the current. Therefore, the current will get divided into total number of parallel paths. These parallel paths will try to repel each other so that the arc will get spread over the contact surface. Such type of arc is called as diffused arc. Why it is called diffused arc? Because the arc does not stay on one particular spot on the contacts. Instead of that, due to the parallel paths of the arc current, it will get spread throughout the contact. So the arc becomes the diffused arc. This type of diffused arc can be interrupted very easily. Next is self-sustained arc. Now at the higher values of current, which is of the order of few thousands ampere, the arc gets concentrated on a small region. Such type of arc which is concentrated on a particular region acts as the self-sustained arc. This arc will cause the rapid vaporization of the metal which is present on the contacts of the circuit breaker. So the transition of arc from the diffused state to the concentrated state will depend upon the following factors. First is material of the contact. Second is magnitude of the current. Third is condition of the electrodes. The interruption of arc is possible when, first, the vapor density varies in phase with the current, and second, when the arc remains in the diffuse state. If the arc is concentrated on one part of the breaker, that is, it becomes a self-sustained arc, then it becomes very difficult to interrupt this type of arc. Now, if the metal vapor is quickly removed from the contact zone, the arc will not strike again. So, once the metal vapors are eliminated from the arc zone, then the arc will not strike again. The dielectric strain between the contacts will build up. It will become greater than the rate of rise of restriking voltage, and so the arc will be eliminated. So, the arc extinction process in vacuum circuit breaker depends upon the following parameters. First is material of the contacts. Second is shape of the contacts. Third is the technique which is adopted for condensing the metal vapor. Then the rapid building up of dielectric strain after the final arc interruption is unique advantage of the vacuum circuit breaker. Now let us study what are the merits of the vacuum circuit breaker. First is that vacuum circuit breaker is a self-contained and it does not require the filling of gas and oil. Then there is no emission of the gases, hence it is pollution free. It is non-explosive. Then the operation of the vacuum circuit breaker is silent. Then it is suitable for capacitive switching, cable switching, as well as industrial load switching. Then the large number of operations on load or the short circuit are possible with the vacuum circuit breaker. Then it is suitable for repeated operation duty. The life of the vacuum circuit breaker is long as compared to other circuit breakers. Now let us study what are the demerits of the vacuum circuit breaker. First demerit is that vacuum interrupters are more expensive as compared to the other interrupters which are used in the other circuit breakers. Then they require very high technology for the production. Now, in the event of loss of vacuum due to transient damage or the failure, the entire interrupter is rendered useless. So, once the vacuum is lost, we cannot use the interrupter. Also, interrupter cannot be repaired on site. Though these were the advantages and disadvantages of the vacuum circuit breaker, in this way we have studied the vacuum circuit breaker. The operation of vacuum circuit breaker is somewhat different from the other circuit breakers. It is basically used for the high capacity switchgear. This type of circuit breaker is basically used for high voltage ratings. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.